people pricing in growth for FY20, and if the managements tend to show that growth. Growth it is that we are talking about. The growth data will be released or due to be released today, and it's likely to show that the Indian economy continued to strengthen in the fourth quarter. But how strong would this recovery be? Ida will tell us what economists are factoring in and what her thoughts are on the same as well. Ida, good morning once again.
Good morning, Neeraj. Growth numbers, it's GDP day, and the expectation is that if anything, you will have a positive surprise, not so much of a negative surprise expected. The Bloomberg survey seems to suggest that the median expectation for growth in the fourth quarter is 7.4%. That would see growth having strengthened over the four quarters of this year steadily as the economy has recovered from first demonetization and the volatility induced by GST. As always, we will be looking at some of the consumption and investment trends within the GDP data to see what the economy structure is looking like. Last quarter, there was a little bit of a hiccup, a small hiccup showing up on the consumption numbers. This is the private final consumption expenditure numbers, which had shown growth of 5.6%. Okay growth, but it had come off compared to Q1 and Q2, so that led to a little bit of nervousness. Now, the expectation is that as the year progressed, rural consumption picked up to add to urban consumption, so you will perhaps see a healthy consumption number. The only caveat to that is that there was a recent report on rural wage growth, and rural wage growth after early signs of picking up again came down to just 3%. So, you know, that question mark over rural recovery, is it entirely been addressed or not? We'll wait to see. You probably won't see it so much in the Q4 numbers, though. We'll see how it plays out in FY19. Investment, fabulously interesting story. You saw 12% growth in gross fixed capital formation. That was a huge surprise when the Q3 numbers came in, but, you know, perhaps a little bit of an outlier. So we want to see how the gross fixed capital formation numbers pan out from here on. We've been speaking on Bloomberg Quint to a number of companies. There are sporadic instances of brownfield capex being announced. Capital goods companies have shown decent order flow. So seems to suggest that there is a modest recovery in private investment, and that modest recovery, perhaps would strengthen as the whole twin balance sheet problem, etc., starts to get resolved. So investment will always be very closely watched out for. Other things to watch out for, net exports. I think economists have been pointing out that net exports have been a drag on GDP because exports have grown slowly while imports have picked up. Does that continue in Q4? It probably will continue in Q4. And then we'll see what happens or what the expectation for next year is, because remember, imports will remain elevated because of the oil factor in FY19 as well. We've been watching at Bloomberg Quint some of the employment intensive sectors to see how they are performing. Manufacturing was strong in Q3 at 8.1%. SBI says that it will remain strong in Q4, and growth may come in at about 9%. Construction strengthened quite steeply in Q3, and financial services was flat. So again, those are two other numbers that you may want to watch out for to assess what the actual health of the economy is. That's the GDP numbers. They come in the second half of the day. You'll also hopefully get the fiscal numbers, the final actual numbers for FY18. And they are backward-looking numbers, but they're very interesting numbers to watch out for, because you will finally in the numbers get confirmation of the increased interim dividend from the Reserve Bank of India, which was required to actually meet the fiscal deficit, the revised fiscal deficit target of 3.5% of GDP for FY18. There was also talk about ploughback of railway capex. So in light of that, we want to see what capital expenditure as a total percentage of GDP looked like in FY18. To some extent, academic interest, Neeraj, not market moving, but, you know, at least the bond markets want to know how those fiscal numbers were met last year, and then, you know, what it says about the health of government finances in FY19 as well.
Okay. Ida, I have one key question on that fixed capital formation that we were talking about, and the numbers looked exaggerated in quarter three. Now, would, because of a low base, while the number, even if it comes out higher, would it be safe to assume that it's difficult to say with a certainty that there is a strong trend building up? It may well show up in quarter four and may well dissipate in quarter one or quarter two of FY19 as well. Is that a realistic possibility?
No, you're absolutely right. I mean, there is the base. There will be the base that will, you know, get built into the year-on-year numbers. But, you know, just look at the commentary around you. Sometimes, you know, in economic analysis, you probably have to marry the data with the commentary around you. You have seen, you know, capital goods companies report relatively decent order flows. You have seen, you know, some one-off capex announcement, maybe not greenfield, or at least brownfield capex announcements starting to come in. We had spoken, I think, months back to Mr. Unnikrishnan of Thermax, who had said that the consumer-facing industries are starting to invest. And then on top of that, you've seen some one-off announcements in sectors like cement, etc. So nobody is saying that we're going to see, you know, very strong private investment in the economy. Some of the underlying issues like excess capacity, continue to persist. But in sectors where that capacity is starting to get used up, maybe we will start to see incremental, private sector demand coming in, investment demand coming in. The expectation or the hope is that as this whole balance sheet problem gets resolved, you will start to see, a little bit of addition to that private investment story. I don't think anybody is expecting, 2011-12 kind of boom in private investment, but perhaps, given where that got us, we shouldn't even hope for that. But there is some spark. I think it's tough to deny that.
Yeah, maybe L&T's confidence also was palpable in their outlook. Yeah, so cool.